and knows nothing about U.S. history, but he was very aggressive as a Trump supporter. Just in your view, as an intelligence professor, professional, you can be a professor if you want, would things like that tend to kind of put him on the radar? I don't know. What do you think of it?
Well, I think I know the question that you're asking. Would coming out, you know, he was sent to you as a representative of the Pennsylvania Republican Party, recommended as someone who would be good on that panel. But as we all know, he is a provocateur of the alt-right. I mean, his job is to go around and he creates conspiracy theories. He's the one who originated the Comet Ping Pong as child sex slave, you know, camp conspiracy theory that led to an armed SWAT siege at that place. He was one of the gentlemen who and ladies who jumped up on a stage at the play of Julius Caesar in New York City. And now he has a history of having been involved in the Macron leaks, which the U.S. Senate Intelligence Committee and the FBI believes may have been a Russian intelligence operation to hack and release information the way that was done in 2016. So he's moved from provocateur onto someone who may have been complicit in a foreign intelligence operation while a U.S. Navy reservist with a top secret SCI clearance. You know,
agent.
It's not going to bode well for his future.
And just to stay with you just for a second.
Agent.
This is a photo of him holding a sign that says, "Rape Melania." That is what the sign said. He went to an anti-Trump protest. This was in January before the inauguration. And he tried to put it there to make it look like he was a member of the anti-Trump protesters. Malcolm, as you just mentioned, he was the guy at the Julius Caesar in Central Park play who was standing up and yelling and trying to interrupt the play. He's a guy who did Pizzagate. He promulgated the hashtag boycott Star Wars because it was too multicultural. I mean, this guy keeps topping up like right-wing Forrest Gump, and then you find out that he is a Navy reservist with who used to have a security clearance. How could somebody with a security clearance, honestly, do all of these openly political activities, and then he eventually actually it got suspended, so he doesn't have it right now. Persobiec did tell NBC News that he was never given an explanation of why his security clearance was suspended, but he suspects it was because he had become more outspoken on Twitter. Are you allowed, if you're a Navy reservist with a security clearance, to do all this political activity?
Let me use this as an opportunity to talk to my brothers and sisters in the intelligence community and say, if you perform provocative political acts, whether you call yourself a journalist or not, and you hold the trust of the U.S. intelligence community with your top secret SCI security clearance, you will lose that clearance. I mean, they snatch clearances for things as innocuous as being late behind a month in your car payment. So Jack Posobiec, for all that's said and done, he has a lot more things going on in his life right now.
They take your clearance for being late for your car payment?
For the alt-right. He is implicated
in the market.
Him and a guy by the name of Mike Cernovich, and that is being investigated by the United States government. The director of NSA, an agency which he would have received information from, has said that they were tracking the Russian hacking related to that, and that the Senate Intelligence Committee is looking for American citizens who may have fostered that Russian intelligence operation, and he was one of the people that created the hashtag Macron leaks. So, you know, for someone who holds a security clearance, do not get involved in these overtly political activities unless you just don't want to work in the community anymore, and that can be facilitated.
And, you know, Kurt, you know, there is this phenomenon of these guys who come out of nowhere and suddenly sort of rise to prominence, at least on the so-called alt-right within that community, that sort of Breitbartian world. How common is it, and how do these guys actually make money?
Well, I think it certainly doesn't hurt when the President of the United States is retweeting your tweets about some of these things. I mean, talk about having the biggest audience, the biggest platform in the world, helping expand your name ID, your brand, your following. You know, these guys get attention, and I think about some of these people like James O'Keefe, remember the guy with all the videos and Acorn and all that? You know, they seek out to create moments, to go viral. And then there are platforms like Breitbart and like Alex Jones who use their large large followings and platforms to help make that go viral, to help get more eyes, the amplification of it. And as they do that, then a lot of folks in the mainstream media then pick up on that, and we end up talking about it. And, you know, it's just this kind of cycle. And they're always, I feel like, looking, it's like a reality TV show. They're always looking for that character.
It's called propaganda.
Latch on to become the target of ire from the media and from political figures. For them, they love it. Every minute that we spend talking about this, they're sitting there going, this is so great, it's working, we're driving them crazy, keep doing it, they fuel it, and it just becomes kind of a self-fulfilling prophecy in some ways.
And I mean, I guess, Malcolm, to a lot of people, they sort of seem like a joke, or they seem sort of silly, but this guy is set apart from those other people, right, because of the job he used to have, I mean, this job he has and the security clearance that he used to have.
You're absolutely right. And, you know, everyone has a right to go out and participate in the political process. There are guidelines so that you don't violate the Hatch Act, so that you're not actually using your position of trust. But you have to understand, when you do provocative things, your behaviors will be looked at. And he lost his clearance. He says, you know, he says he didn't, but his clearance was suspended by DONCAF, the Navy Adjudication Authority for Top Secret Security Clearances, because there was reporting that said because he had leaked classified information on Twitter. I don't know whether that's true or not, but I can tell you this much. His behaviors are a breach of trust for all of the hundreds of thousands of people who hold a top secret clearance, who don't use their experience and training to go out and act as a political agent provocateur, which he revels in, as they said.
Yeah, and he's pretty belligerent in a focus group, too. I can tell you from personal experience. Malcolm Mann, Kurt Bardella, thank you guys. Really appreciate it. And up next, thank you, more on the Trump